Kevin Cassidy, so IFL TV, Paris Sports by Blast, and joined by John Finney. John, you've done a bit of weight, haven't you?
Listen, I do a bit of training every day when I can, you know, nothing heavy at my stage of the game, but you know what? It's more of an habit, less than effort, you know what I'm saying? But I enjoy it, you know. Listen, I'm 56. A lot of people can't do it, but you know, I try to keep going the best way I can. Good days and bad days, that's what it's about, but I keep going through them all.
That's what life's about, though, isn't it?
Absolutely, in every aspect. Good days and bad days.
You just pray for more good days and bad days, is it?
Well, I can handle the bad days as well. I've had plenty of them, as you well know, Coogan.
Do you think we worry about the wrong things in life in general?
Absolutely. Nothing's more important than health and strength. And a bit of contempt and happiness. If you've got them, you're wealthy, aren't you? The rest is all bollocks, isn't it?
Correct.
Oh, shite. And all these plastic people. You know, and all these socialistic friends.
They do. I think generally people worry about the wrong things.
Yeah, me. Reality checks most from me, don't they? You know, all that is just an illusion, and it's not really happening, it's not really there. You know, but true friends are there when you need them. The plastic ones are gone. When you can do no more for them, you know, that's life. But it's up to you to be clever enough to see that, spot it, and get rid of them, innit?
Well, someone in boxing once said to me, look who's in the training room when a fighter gets beat.
Yeah, no one.
You ain't had that problem yet,
no.
To be fair. And God,
I've had it myself.
Yeah, no, but with your
never even got a lift home.
You haven't had that problem yet. But what? You, with your children, you've not suffered that.
No, problem, no, yet. Listen, I'm proud of all my sons, and number one. You know, without them, my life would be meaningless, you know what I'm saying? Because believe me, they've excelled in everything what they do, even if they don't box like Tyson. Whatever they chose to do in life, they've done very well with it. And I'm proud of them all, every one of them.
So you should have known.
Well, aye. What does fathers do? Be proud of their offspring.
I've just become a father. Well, I hope my daughter don't become a boxer. I really don't. Anything else, ballet, dance or whatever. Yeah. Don't get into boxing.
Listen, I love women's boxing. Like, but I couldn't see one of my granddaughters doing it, you know, because the pain would be too much.
I'll categorically say now, my daughter is not going to be a boxer.
It'd be too painful for me, that, you know, and then my grandkids, you know what I'm saying? So, listen, you got my heart goes out to all the fathers are seeing the daughters, pretty young things, like getting beat up.
It must be a different feeling.
Oh, it's got to be. I couldn't cope with it. I could not cope with that. So all them guys out there who's coping with it, big up to you. You're better man than me.
Anyone out there on the old PC brigade, that ain't a sexist comment. That's just generally being a father. Seeing your children, your boys go through a boxing career, getting punched in the face is one thing. But seeing your daughter do it, it's a different thing. And I don't care what anyone says. That ain't a sexist comment. That's honest. Being a father.
But people's got different feelings, you know, and whatever they do and whatever they don't, if they do well in the sport, they'd be probably as proud as what I am, but the pain has got to be more, because now it's watching my sons do it, you know, and that's pretty painful for me. So God bless all of them, and good luck to all the lady boxers out there. You know, good luck with it. It's expanding by the day, isn't it? It's all getting more popular by the hour.
Absolutely. John, we've got to talk about the tour that's been going halfway through it now.
Yeah.
We know what people coming to watch Tyson get, because they get more than value for money.
He excels, don't he?
And he's answering all the questions we want him to answer. And yeah, it's been great. What?
He's a.
What did you want?
Yeah, he's a singer, he's a dancer, he's an entertainer. Outside the ring as well as in it. Yeah, but he's a good time, ain't he? People get value for money and they always want more, don't they? And that's what it's about, putting smiles on people's faces in down times like we're living in now. Because they are down times, aren't they?
Are they?
Of course, you don't know where they're going. You don't know where we're at, do you? You don't know where you're going to be locked down. You could be locked down tomorrow. What are you going to do? I'm alive and I thank God every day for it. But I don't want no more in my life than to be alive. There's people want a lot more than that, don't they? They're not happy just to be alive and healthy. They want a lot more, don't they, because they're greedy.
No, but a minimum requirement in life.
To be alive.
Just be healthy and alive
of
and happy.
Of course, absolutely. You know what? If you can be like me and enjoy it, I'm enjoying, you know. It's icing on the cake, ain't it? But even if my son wasn't where he is today, I'd still be this kind of a man. You know, because I take life as it comes, one day at a time, and enjoy it. You know, as long as I go to bed without a problem, I'm happy enough. But if I get the problems, I'll deal with them like I've dealt with them all my life. So, nothing's new.
John, listen, I know you're obviously on the tour with Tyson doing a bit now. I'm going to take too much of your time for that. But I do want to ask you about this reported 40 million that Anthony Joshua apparently to step aside to allow your boy to fight Usyk. I'm not going to say I know that 40 million is accurate. I don't believe it is, to be honest with you.
But if it is, do you see Joshua stepping aside to allow his son to fight Alexander Usyk?
Well, it's business boxing, and I do believe AJ wants to fight Usyk. That's why he's asked 40 million. You know, because if he's like, you know.
Can you blame him?
No, not at all. I'd ask 70 million. So good luck, AJ. You know, it's business. But I do believe AJ wants to avenge his loss. And he can bounce back. He's proved it. You know, at 40 million, if somebody's big enough to pay it, then I'm pay it. You know what? Definitely, I think AJ wants a fight. Usyk, that's why he's asked the kind of money. But it's good business to take it. But if they can arrange a sensible offer, that's if he wants to go down this road. Get a chunk of money for nothing and a crack at the winner. You've had a double whammy, haven't you? But you know, in AJ's case now, it's not about the money. It's more of a pride thing with him, and I don't blame the lad, you know. But I've had a lot of good nights with him. He's a brilliant athlete, you know. Let's not kick a man while he's down. He's better than that, you know.
John, I want to say one thing. In the couple of interviews I've done with AJ last month,
yeah.
Listen, when he's talking about your son, you know it's business.
Business, nothing's personal.
But he's always respectful about you.
Oh, thank you, man. Thank you, AJ. Appreciate it.
No, he is. He has got me. Listen,
I would never, ever have any malice or bad feeling to toward another man's son. He's a mother's son and a father's son. Even if he's fighting my son, it's business. And the best man will win, whatever it may be, you know. And whatever happens in a fight, you shake hands afterwards. And you've noticed all boxers, at the end of a fight, they show ultimate respect, don't they? And I'm sure AJ's no different, mate. He's a lovely human being. I've had a lot of good nights with the lad, you know. Even Eddie here, it's all bantering. Mile for a minute. Come on. Yeah, it's only about 4 minutes.
You said you wanted to bury him the other day.
In shame. Bury him in shame. There's a difference. Not kill him. Bury him in shame. But I'm only joking again. You know,
boxing,
I had too many tequilas when I made the video.
John, boxing is a business.
It's a business.
And then people say things.
Of course they do.
And it's always about building the potential fight or fight coming up.
Listen, there's no stupid thing on either side, you know. It's all good fun. It's what people want to hear and see. They'll pay for it, you know. But you know, it can get out of hand, can't it? But at the end of the day, we're all the best of pals, mate.
So just to confirm, you don't want to sway them with any other?
No, because he'd probably beat me.
John, listen,
I've known him a long time,
know
his dad years, you know.
Watching the interviews and videos know they're taking a pinch of salt. I don't think anyone's generally thinking John Fury wants to say about any other.
No, it's all savoury banter, you know, and at the end of the day, if it gets people interested and puts a smile on the face, it's a good thing, isn't it? You know, it's all business, it's a fight game. But when them boys get in the ring, that's when the real action starts, isn't it? The rest is all build-up, banter, what people want. Where would boxing be without it, though?
Good question.
Where would it be without it? Because if they didn't need it, you wouldn't need a promoter, would you?
Absolutely.
You know, and Eddie Hearn's good at his job. You know, so Frank Warren's good at his job. You know, I love them all, me. Because without them in this game, my life would be pretty dull, you know. And I've got to have somebody to have a bit of a laugh with, haven't
I? John, finally, I do want to ask you about Tyson's situation with Dillian White. Very unclear in a minute. We don't know what's happening with regards to WBC, but you've got no problem about Tyson facing Dillian White.
Not at all,
you know.
If he has
respect for Dillian White
100%,
as well.
Of course he have, yeah. Listen, again, business. If it's good business to fight Dillian White, we fight him. And like Tyson said, he's shying away from no man, because that's not his business. He will fight anybody, the promoters and the business people put in front of him. If the business side of it's happy, he ain't bothered who he fights. You know, Dillian White's entitled to his shot. He has waited 10 million days, like Tyson said. So, yeah, I hope the kid does get his shot against my son. But we're after the bit bigger fry at the minute. And the bit bigger fry is Usyk and AJ. They're the two biggest names on the planet. I do believe once Tyson has met them and dealt with them, he'll be moving on, win, lose, or draw.
Why do you want him to retire?
Because he can't do anymore. He's won everything in a professional.
He can't do anymore, but you just mentioned two opponents that he's
yeah,
not faced.
That's him. Because his heart and soul's in fighting Usyk and Joshua. And the chapter won't be shut on the Tyson Fury thing till that's been accomplished
so
by him.
Why would you want him to retire now?
He's got kids that need him and he's never there. And I know what it is. I was a good father to these, I still am. You know, and those kids miss him. And he's never home. He's always in camp. When he's back, you know, camps are that monotonous. You know, he likes a laugh and a joke. And he has got other responsibilities and duties to young children. You know, because what are they going to be if he's absent all the time? you've defeated the object, enough's enough. But listen, Tyson's own man, you know, none of us are greedy. He's made plenty of money, two-time world champion, he's had all the belts in his possession, he's got everyone in his house, what more can he do? But that's Tyson, he will fight on with those two people. You know, if Dillian White's in the mix, good luck to him. That's all I can say, but good luck to all them men. It's a dangerous sport, you know, but in defeat, you've got to be more honourable in defeat than what you have in victory. And I do believe any one of them men can do that and accomplish it. But I say good luck to them all. And if I've offended anybody along the way, I apologise, because that's just John Fury, but I'm not changing for nobody. Because a man I don't want, no, can't be bought, can I?
No, I know.
You know, and I love all them blue tick companies. You know, they're fabulous people, even give a dosser like me a chance. But listen, I do the best I can, you know.
My opinion, sir, I know what you're referring to. And yeah. I think I've been interviewing you, whatever you...
A long time.
What year did you come out of prison?
Early 15.
Right, so since you come out of prison, I've been interviewing you.
Yeah.
And you never swear.
No,
you
try
never
not
talk
to.
Talk anything. And I think the moment that you do have kind of getting a little bit emotionally involved, because it's to do with Tommy, yeah, people jump on the bandwagon and want to say, oh, disrespectful, blah, 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 blah. But over the years, you don't really talk like that, Tommy.
Listen, no, you know, I've got respect for everybody, even the Jake Pauls, the Logan Pauls, everybody that goes in that ring I've got respect for. You know, but he has said some naughty things about Molly May.
Absolutely.
And Tommy, he's not like me, he's a different character, he's a very inward boy, you know, and he's my youngest son. And if I can defend him, I will do. I'll defend his missus as well. And my own missus. Defend them till the day I die.
Listen, I like Jake Paul. Jake Paul has said some bad things about Molly over the last 2 years. So no one's bringing that up.
It's unsavoury banter. No harm meant. But did I swear on the interview on that press conference? No.
Don't ever swear.
But it meant the same. I know it meant the same. It meant the same, but you know what? Good people know there's no harm in John Fury. There's no harm in John Fury. And anybody who's took offence, I'll apologise. Because I'm a big enough man to do that. You know, and I know all them people that see things different than me. The educated ones, I call them. I'm sorry to you all. You know, it's all unsavoury banter. No, it's not pleasing to the ears, but you know what? People must like it. They watch it, don't they? It went viral anyway.
Viral, but I think people got to realise
that's your son.
Yes, of course. But people who understand the fight game and people out there, we are in the fight game.
Do you know what I understand? The boxers going there to punch each other's faces in and tear each other's heads off. And they're being offended by your comments, please.
There's been a lot worse happening in boxing than whatever I could say 100%. Or do. You know what I'm saying? But I know my limits, I know where to go with it, but at the end of the day, the army kids, and it can be a cheeky boy, Jake Paul, but I can be a cheeky man. So it's all good business, isn't it? You know,
it
like
talking point.
The talking point's what it is, isn't it? But I apologise to BT Sport, I know I've ruffled a few feathers there, but that's up to them.
But that's their situation.
That's their situation, not mine.
Company and
that's
we
right.
Get that. We get that.
I get that, you know, and at the end of the day. But listen, it went viral. That's what you meant to do on a press conference, so get up there, my boy!
John Fury, thank you very much.
Thank you, Coogan. Right. Let's get pissed now, shall we?
Well, I'm on the water tonight.
Well,
don't be a
crap. Well,
no,
no.
You're not one.
Oh, definitely not. You're John, sober as a judge.
Definitely know you're not one.
You're as sober as a judge, but I'm not. I've had a bottle of brandy already.
A little bit of that.
Listen. I've done one bottle of brandy. I'm on my second. Well, with all these good people. I'm enjoying Cardiff, the crowd, my son. It's been amazing.
And we're alive.
We're alive, and thank God every
go.
Day for that.
There we go.
God bless you, people.
John Fury, thank you very much.
Thank you all for your support, and everybody out there, even the haters, I love you. God bless you.
Love the haters.
That's the one.
Always say love the haters.
You're always going to be hated. Everybody don't love you, do they?
You're nobody. If you ain't hated by someone, you're nobody.
God bless you, Coogan.
God bless you, mate.
Appreciate it.